Jaega. Begin this joyous ceremony together. Dearly beloved and friends, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in the holy estate of matrimony, which is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If any man can show just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let him or her now speak, or hereafter forever hold their peace. I require and charge you both, as ye shall answer in the great day of judgment, when all secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediments why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you should now confess it. For be it well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise as God's law does allow, their marriage is not lawful. Who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
Take her care of her. He's a good girl.
Yes, sir.
Everybody can hear me. Yeah. Oh, I didn't know it was a microphone. I
Kendall, will I have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Justine, will I have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou love him and honor him and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
This is the most sacred part of your wedding ceremony, and so I want you to face one another holding hands. Kendall, would you repeat after me? I, Kendall.
I, Kendall.
Take thee, Justine.
Take thee, Justine.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
From better, for worse.
for richer, for poor.
From richer, from poor.
In sickness and in health.
From sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
To death do us part.
To death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I pledge you my love.
I pledge you my love.
Justine, would you repeat after me? I, Justine.
I, Justine.
Take thee, Kendall.
Take thee, Kendall.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I pledge you my love.
I pledge you my love.
Let's all pray together. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Father God, we are so grateful and thankful for Kendall and Justine. Thank you for allowing them to meet and fall in love and decide to live together eternally. We ask now that you would bless them, their marriage, their union, and all that they seek to do in thy name. Surround them, bless them, and keep them. And I pray that you would strengthen them each day of their lives. I thank you now for the ceremony and the commitment that they have made one to another. In Jesus' name we pray by faith. Amen.
Amen.
Kendall, Justine, what do you have to symbolize the commitment that you have made one to another today?
Rings.
Wonderful.
Oh, sorry.
Kendall, Justine, these rings are made out of precious metal. We're symbolizing the wedding ceremony that they will never tarnish or fade, and the love that you have for one another this day, this moment, should never tarnish or fade. These rings are also made in a circle. There's no beginning, no end. We know there's a beginning to your relationship, but it symbolizes in this wedding ceremony that your love for one another should never end. Kendall, take this ring and place it upon the third finger of Justine's left hand. Hold the hands together. Repeat after me, Kendall. With this ring.
With this ring.
I wear thee.
I wear thee.
And with all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Justine, would you take this ring? Place it upon the third finger of Kendall's left hand. And hold the hands. Would you repeat after me? With this ring.
With this ring.
I wed thee.
I wed thee.
And with all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Wonderful. The commitment you have made together. Listen, this is a great couple, a fine couple today. And you guys have just made this commitment one to another. Listen, what therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Kendall and Justine have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and hereto have given and pledged their love each to the other, and have declared the same by the giving and the receiving of rings and by the joining of hands, I now pronounce that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Kendall, this is the part you've been waiting on. You may now kiss your lovely bride.
Love you too.
Too much?
My bad.
Wonderful. Listen, this is a lovely couple, and this is a lovely day, and we all are here to celebrate their love and their union together. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Kendall Aldridge. Would everyone please stand?